was fun. It was funny. We, John and I, are big believers in political reporting being about one person at a time. And so I thought this way to launch online was a way to talk to one voter at a time. And it was amazing how many people jumped at the opportunity to tell us what we were doing wrong or what we were doing right. And my favorite thing was how many of the comments that were instantaneous were about what we normally don't show them, the breaks in the commercial, the music. And that was really fun. We also, the thing that everybody wanted to know were how comfortable were these red chairs.
They're very, very comfortable.
They're good, yeah.
And so it was neat to see, I guess, in this age of instant response, it was fun to have the entire internet community feel like what it is in a control room. Like, just like you at home are yelling at the TV saying, wait, what do you mean by that? What is it? It's so fun to let that control room out. And that was neat, and that was different for me.
Michelle, when you came up with this idea, you not only wanted it to stream live, but the Facebook conversation on the side of CNN.com was incredibly important to you. Why did that chat segment was so important?
Well, one of the things that, you know, John did so beautifully last year was going to all 50 states in 50 weeks, which was so hard. And so this is a way to still travel. I mean, when you have 74% of 18 to 34-year-olds on Facebook, I mean, that is staggering. And I joke with John that, you know, during March Madness, this is when more people are active online than ever. And so this was kind of it's always a great time to have a political show, but I feel like right now, with the moment, with every vote, it was so perfect and instantaneous at a time when people are online for March Madness anyway. Let's get that instant feedback, that conversation, and go where the people are. And so a lot of people watch CNN with their laptops, and especially noon to one is a time when most people are blogging and checking their information. And so to be in the mix and in the room of that momentum shift is so cool, and to share that experience. Like, it's so funny. I think as we keep growing as a society, we keep yearning for those events that bring us together and connect us. And CNN.com is like the place to do it.
So what were they asking? What were the viewers
John,
asking?
John, tons of tweets about the music you guys selected.
Tweets about the music?
Most people love the music. How did you choose the music?
We want to have a good mix of music. We want to have lively music. Some of the music, if you listen closely or if you're familiar with it, will be about political things or we're part of a political movement. And some of it's just to have a little fun. We all like music. I have sort of wacky range of musical tastes. I could be listening to Sinatra one second and Janet Jackson the next. And you know, my children have brought me into a whole new world of music. Some of it I actually like, and some of it I just go like this. But so we want that to be part of the program because it's part of people's lives. It is part of the rhythm of people's lives. And it's important in politics, too. It's important. And a lot of these politicians, you know, one of the things we want to learn about them as we go on, and hopefully they'll let us post it. You know, what's on your iPod? What do you listen to when you're having your toughest day? You know, that's what I do. I put on my, you know, pop in the earphones and have my moment of zen with some music. And so that's part of who we are.
Guns N' Roses on CNN. I think I'm in heaven. That's what someone wrote here. And they like generally good stuff on the jeans, right?
Yeah. A lot of comments about when people saw your jeans, they were very
maybe
excited.
Maybe darker. One person did say you may want to go with
darker
wash.
Darker wash. They're probably right. These ones are a little beat up.
This is meaty stuff. Yeah.
And the staff had a little bit of a code to wear the t-shirts and the jeans.
The school uniform is our leader told us. The jeans is an interesting question because I want people to be comfortable here, and I want to be comfortable here. When I'm on the road, I tend to wear jeans. When I'm in your community, you know, the last thing you need if I'm coming to a factory or a diner or you know your school committee meeting is some guy from Washington in a suit who doesn't fit into your community. I grew up in a blue-collar neighborhood. I like jeans. It's what I wear. There is a question here, and we'll work out that rhythm. Some days you'll see me in a suit and tie out of respect for the people we're interviewing. Because that's their uniform at work. And to the degree that they're comfortable and to the degree that it fits, I'll wear jeans sometimes. To the degree that, out of respect for my guest, anybody who comes here is a guest in my home, if their job has them in a suit, they're more comfortable in that setting, well, then you know, I deserve to show them that respect. So we'll go back and forth a little bit. And, you know, this is the first day. Second day will be different. Second week will be different. Second month will be different. Hopefully we'll be here for a second year and it will be different. So we'll just go with the rhythm and we'll learn. But if there are things out there that you like and don't like, please let us know. And if we don't do what you think we should do, that doesn't mean we're not listening. We'll get there as we go.